All bets on sports.
What is bet?
Huge winnings.
What is bet?
High odds.
What is bet?
Fast pay.
What is bet? What is bet?
Bookmaker Company.
This week you've been late.
I know. I've just got finished the deadline that I planned, I promise. When I get back, maybe I can find a way to make it up to you.
Well, Friday night we do have the nanny.
Oh, then I will see you on Friday night, lady.
If you're lucky. Night.
Are you really scared, Mom?
I was. But next time, let's get your dad.
Okay.
Looks like Mr. Brown could use a cuddle.
Mom. I'm too old to still sleep with the teddy bear.
Well, I won't tell if you won't. Good night.
Good night, Mom.
Doing.
No.
I thought we could take a look at some of those toys today. Or perhaps there's something you'd like to talk about. You don't like coming here very much, do you? But you do understand why you're here. You know, Jude, if you'd like to go, all you need to do is to say, I'd like to go now. Months isn't an unusual time for this kind of selective mutism. I've seen children stop talking for much longer from much less severe trauma. Encourage him to communicate, but try not to force it. It has to come from him. The more we force things, the more he's going to pull back. And how are the two of you holding up?
We're good, yeah. As well as we can be.
We're really just trying to focus on Jude's recovery right now. Well, I commend your dedication, but Jude is looking to you now, and if you're not getting better, he won't get better.
Thank you. The dog had some good things to say.
Yeah. I think Jude is a little better.
I meant actually about us healing too.
Well, I'm fine, really.
You never leave the house. You have nightmares every night.
Having this conversation again.
We've never had this conversation. You've never talked about what happened or how you feel. What if we went away? Out of the city, someplace quiet. You're already homeschooling, Jude. I can work wherever. I think it would be a good chance for us to have a fresh start.
I'm glad you found it. This used to be a guest house of a much larger property, but after the owner of the manor house passed away, some city man, no offence, came and scooped it up. I think he was going to restore it, but I imagine the job got too much for him. Lucky for you folks though, it's Some time in the countryside? It's perfect. I'll give you a little tour if you like.
No, I think we can handle it from here.
Oh, all right.
Thank you.
Take care.
Cheers. Bye-bye. So, what do you think?
It's beautiful.
Yeah, you sure?
Yes.
And what about you, Big Boss? All right. I vote we try a little nature exploration. Come on, dude. Wow. This place must have been quite something back in the day.
Glenview Estate.
It's probably got some real history to it.
Sean.
Forget the guest house. I'm moving in here.
What do you say, Jude? Jude?
Hey, don't run off like that, please.
You can't run off like that, not out here.
What's that? You just find that? Take a look. Oh my goodness, it's filthy in the fit. Whereabouts did you find it?
Do you want to keep it? Okay, let's get it cleaned up first.
Right, can't wait to have this guy in the house.
I bet you have a story to tell. Looks like he wants a friend. Looks like he was broken before. Together again. Okay, let's go to bed now. Huh?
Come on, mate. You sure you got everything you need, the little fella? Yeah? You just
Just make yourself at home, put your feet up. Nice cold beer in the fridge. I could use some of those PJs.
You dressed him yourself. That sounds lovely. Are you hungry? Okay. I'll make pancakes.
Guess it's about time for me to start my morning commute. All the way down the hallway. Really hope there's no traffic, guys. I'm gonna stop by the office for lunch today. I mentioned that I was just down the hallway.
I'll try to sneak by.
Goodbye, Jester. Mwah. Goodbye, did we come up with a name for him yet? That's quite the name. How'd you come up with that? Oh, he told you. I'm right. Yeah. Of course he did. Silly me. All right. Bye, gang. Goodbye, Brahms.
Well, what should we start with today? Math or history? To run off like that. This is where you found him?
Oswald Kennedy. This is private property.
I'm sorry, we're staying at the guest house. We were just on a walk. I didn't know.
Of course, you're the new family. Sorry, I get a lot of people snooping around up here. I'm Joseph, Joe. I tend the ground trap here. Park guard, park gardener. This is Oz.
I'm Liza, and this is Jude. We can put the doll back. Do you want to...
No. Keep it. No one's going to miss it out here. Just me and Oz these days. Unless, of course, he fights to put it back.
He's a little quiet.
About that. Not much of a talker myself. People think I'm crazy for living out here on my own, but I'm more sane than any of them. Real crazies living in the city, packed together like a bunch of cattle. Thank you, but no, thank you.
You didn't really have to walk us all the way back.
Oh, I don't mind. We're neighbours now. I suppose we've seen quite a bit of you.
Hey there. Is that a healthy looking 12 gauge?
Or a 12 ball.
This is Joseph. Joseph, this is my husband, Sean.
Hiya.
Joseph.
I attend the grounds around here. Keep the troublemakers out. Got these two red-handed.
Yeah, these two are trouble, all right. Well, thanks for escorting them back.
Right, I'll be off then. Let me know if you need anything.
Yeah. Nice meeting you.
Pleasure was all mine. See you soon, little fella.
Bringing down the local strays already, huh?
He's right there. He insisted on walking us all the way home.
Come on, Arthur. Come on.
Nice of him, I guess.
I mean, who the hell buries a doll in the woods like that?
Maybe some weird little kid put it there. I don't know, sweetheart.
I mean, you weren't there. You didn't see it. His entire wardrobe. In this coffin thing.
Okay. What do you want to do? Want to take the doll away from him?
Yes. No. I just think it's all over.
It's the dome, that's the problem here.
What does that mean?
Nothing. Let's just finish the dishes, yeah. That's what I have to do before we go to sleep.
No, I want to hear what you were about to say. What's the problem?
Sometimes I feel like you use Jude to avoid talking about what happened to you, and I don't think that's healthy for either of you.
I nearly died in some random senseless burglary. And I'm actually aware of that every single day of my life.
Yes, but that's not right now.
Hi.
What were you guys talking about?
About the dog from this morning.
Did he scare you?
Brahms doesn't like it. No. That's great.
Let you get back to Brahms.
Yeah. Thinking about watching a movie, if you're interested.
too, yeah. Surprised you too.
Hey, good morning. You're up. I let you lie in.
You'd use it.
Yeah. What happened to Mr. Brown? Jude? Buddy? What'd you do this?
Come on, mate. It's not very nice to blame him now, is it?
Look, we're not mad at you. But this is no way to treat your things. And it's never okay to lie. So did you cut up Mr. Brown? Then why don't you go to your room and finish your homework there, and then when you're ready to tell me what happened, you can come out. You can leave the doll here.
Jude, you heard your mum. Leave the doll, please. Maybe it's a good thing he's getting his anger out.
It's pretty violent. You're supposed to stay in this room and not come out again until you're ready to apologize. Fine. You can stay in here for the rest of the day then. Jude, your father and I said no doll. Okay, I'm gonna count to three, and if this door isn't open, one, two, three.
Someone here wants to apologize. Come on.
Thank you for apologizing.
Okay, let's get you to bed, yeah?
I could have sworn I saw somebody go into his room, and then...
You didn't. It's fine. Honestly, his pranks are getting out of hand.
Yeah, but I thought everything would be better once we got out of the city. I don't know what to do. I just feel like I'm letting you and Jude down.
Don't let anyone down. Please let me sorry. You feel better after some sleep.
That some of Jude's recent behaviors would be upsetting. But the doll clearly is providing him with a safe outlet to process his trauma. Now comes the hard part, where he might... and allow him to have his friend. He's found a place with this doll where he feels safe, and the last thing we want to do is take that away. I'll send you some links with further information.
Okay, sounds good. Thanks, Doc. I'll speak to you soon, yeah?
Okay, take care.
Jude. You got it.
Okay.
You thought of a name for him yet? What is it? Of course it is. That's his name, isn't it? What else would it be? Scrubbed up well, little man. So, I see you found yourself a new family. Just look at that expression on his face. Like he's got a secret that only he knows. You ever notice that?
Can I help you?
Hold on there. I was just looking for Ross, my daft dog.
We haven't seen him.
All right, don't worry. Pretty good idea where he'll be anyway. Right, I'll be off. You'll be good now.
Come on. It's time to go inside.
All bets on sports.
What is fair?
Huge winnings.
What is fair?
High odds.
What is fair?
Fast pay.
What is fair? What is fair?
Bookmaker Company.
Sorry. I didn't know you were standing there. Why are you wearing that? Dinner's at 15. Thank you.
It's just the three of us for dinner tonight, Jude. No, not tonight.
Does it really matter, Liza? Your mum said no, mate. So I was thinking of inviting Liam out, family. Maybe we could do some company. No? Want your Uncle Liam, Auntie Mary and your cousin? I think it'd be fun. He's always a good laugh, isn't he? I think he'll look to get out of the city. Not really guests. Family. Yeah?
No, your dad and I make the rules in this house, not your dog.
Come on, enough.
No, it's fine. You can sit here until you decide you can eat your food.
Just do as your mom says. Please.
If you won't talk to me on the doll, that's because Brahms is not a person. He's not real. He doesn't need any food. You do. The doll and his rules do not run this house. Stay here all night then.
Some scary drawings. I mean, it's not really surprising, is it, considering what he's been through?
The drawing of the dog.
The dog? There is no dog here.
There was one, and others. Sean, there was a drawing of Jude standing over our dead bodies, and he was holding a gun.
So you're saying he ripped pages out of his book?
No, I don't know what happened. Doing to June? What?
I mean, all of this. This is a lot for a little kid, don't you think? I mean, this isn't a light table for starters.
Are you asking me if I did this?
Somebody's done this. You're the only person in here with him.
Come in. June.
Thank you.
I'm sorry I scared you. You were just playing, Mommy.
So good to hear your voice.
Over you, didn't you hear us calling?
No.
Jude, what the hell are you doing in here? It's not safe.
I'm sorry, Daddy.
Jude, he's talking.
Right, let's go. We're not really supposed to be in this part of the house. Shelf browse the music room.
Stay close, mate.
There was a family that lived a long time ago. Had a son, went a bit mad, killed a little girl, got burnt up in fire, wore a mask to hide. Lived inside the walls of the house for 30 years, never came out.
The Hillshires?
Yeah, the Hillshires.
And?
And the parents committed suicide, drowned themselves. Very sad story.
And the son?
Well, it all got a bit messy after the parents had gone. He killed a man, very nearly two others, before he was killed himself. But they're all dead and buried now.
What's the son's name?
His name was Brahms.
Did you say Brahms?
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to keep it from you. I just didn't think it'd ever come up.
Thank you for telling us. Come on, Jude. It's time to go home.
Hey, Joseph. Did you ever find your dog?
Yes, I did. I'm afraid Oz was found gutted in the forest.
Sorry to hear that.
So your parents tell me you've been talking again. Is this your new friend, Brahms? He seems like a very nice friend. What are some of the things you talk about?
He tells me all sorts of things. Sometimes he tells me about the other families he's lived with.
Oh, has he lived with a lot of families?
He wants to live with us now. He was very angry that Mommy and Daddy wanted to take him away.
Oh. And when Brahms gets angry, does he say he wants to hurt someone or something? Is there something he wants to tell your Mum and Dad? Well, if Jude had something to do with the dog's death, then this is a lot more serious than we thought. The doll might be enabling him to shift blame for all the bad things that he might do. I think it would be a good idea for me to see him face to face. When do you think you can bring him down to London?
We've got guests coming today, but we'll bring him as soon as we can.
All right then, but I urge you keep a close eye on him in the meanwhile.
Jude's is a friend of mine.
Okay, children, why don't we go outside and play while we
We'll have a catch-up.
Yes.
There's nothing to do outside.
There's nature. Right? It's like a video game. But real. Oh, enjoy.
Come on, Jude. Show them around.
Maybe I should go with them.
Oh, nonsense. I'll be fine. Just stay close to the house, guys.
I like your doll.
Thanks. This place sucks. There's nothing to do here.
We could play croquet.
I want to play. Come on.
Don't touch him, Sophie. He's mental.
No, I'm not.
My parents say you talk to that doll. Like it's a real person. Because you went crazy when your mom got attacked. And we're not supposed to notice.
We'll.
But they know you're mental. And I know you're mental. And your stupid doll, the most mental of all.
He's fine, Liza. Have some wine. You're doing good to hang out with some other children. Ever since it happened, I can't seem to relax. Hey, you're with family now. You don't have anything to worry about. Will won't let anything happen.
Hey, you're breaking it!
Shut up, Nutter.
Stop it, Will!
Ooh, you're sticking up for your Nutter boyfriend now. Maybe I should just smash your door. Maybe that will make you normal again.
Tom.
We get to this party and we have literally just walked in the door and his pants split right in the bum. And not just a little tear, the whole bum.
I'm going to tell Mom.
She'll probably be happy.
Don't touch him.
Or what?
He'll make you wish you never came here.
Did you buy him purple boxers? I did. Oh, it's good to see that smile again, Liza. That old smile of yours.
Give it back!
Nah, I don't think I will.
Give it back to her.
Give it back!
Ooh, now your boyfriend's mad. Why'd you come get it from me, mental?
You know, I wouldn't worry about this doll thing. Will used to be obsessed with this blanket.
Run, mental, run!
Stop it, Will!
Obsessed. But then one day I realized that it was quite literally a security blanket. And I think this doll could be the same thing.
Come on, Mental.
You shouldn't worry about it, is what I'm saying. Kids do all sorts of weird things. They go through phases. And then poof, it's gone.
It's okay.
to go. He wants me to live in the big house with them forever.
He said he'd kill you and Daddy if I didn't do it. He said that.
When did he say that? He says it all the time. I can't control him anymore.
Hey, Liz, it's me. Just saw the doctor. I think Will's gonna be okay. So, I'll call you from the car.
From around here, are you?
I'm staying at the Glenview Estates.
Glenview? Oh, you mean the Heelshire place? Christ, you couldn't pay me money to stop there.
You what?
You don't know. Whole family went completely mad out of there. Something to do with a son living inside the walls for years. But that's not the only thing that happened out there. There were other tragedies before. Back in the 50s, a kid killed his own mother and brother, convinced a dog was speaking to him. And it's still going on. Last year, that city man, that boy after the Hillshires, went a bit mad. Disappeared. Never heard from again. Saw him down the pub one time. Old Crazy Joe.
Crazy Joe?
Oh, that's what people called him like. Yeah, his name was Joseph. So...
I just want to know where my son is. I will do anything you want. Just get on my son.
I want you to listen!
He wants you to listen! You ask me why I'm here. It's the same reason that you are. He called me. He calls out to the ones that need him. The damaged ones. He looks inside you. It was just a whisper. At first. When I first came in. So quiet. And he was in pieces when I found him. Broken. And then the voice said to put him back together. So I did. Then I heard groan inside. She must have heard it. Jude, sure has. Holy.
I don't know what Brahms is. But you can stop this.
It's too late. Brahms and Jude are going to be one, and it'll be beautiful. You see, everybody thought that I was crazy. They thought the heels used to be crazy, but Oral. It's always been the door. Even before the house, before the Davies, the ones before that, I found all their old letters. He knew. That's why he told me to bury him. They're always so curious, aren't they? The little ones are like moths to a flame.
Joseph, where is my son? I want to see my son!
He's in the big house!
Brahms. I used to hold you just like this. Let's just put him down.
Mom.
June, put the gun down.
I'm very angry. You and Daddy have been getting in the way. We're going to live here now. Because you can't protect us.
Protect you from who?
That dog. Well, and those men from that night.
You're right. We do need promise to protect us.
It's too late. You've given us no choice. Goodbye, Mommy.
I know. Brahms is telling you what to say, which is why we need to take him home with us. Brahms needs to be a member of our family. And what kind of a family doesn't need a mother?
Taste it, because I'm pretty confident that this might be the greatest coq au vin ever made upon English shores. I'm not even joking. There's a whole bottle of wine here, so I'm not sure if... No, okay, I'll
take it.
Thank
you. All right. This looks so good.
Thank you. Just 2 or 3 hours of my day, you know, nothing much. Yeah. Good night, my man. Sleep tight.
I love you, sweetie.
Love you, too. learn the rules.